So as the name suggests, in the coaxial cable, the axis will be same for the all layers. So the coaxial cable consists of a stiff copper wire as the core, surrounded by an insulating material. So as you can see from the figure, there is a core of a copper cable. Above that, the insulating material is used. And above that insulating material, the cover, that is braided outer conductor, is used. And above the braided outer conductor, there is a layer of protective plastic covering. Okay, so this is how a coaxial cable is formed. Alright, here the outer conductor is covered in the protective plastic sheet. So here the data transmission loss may be less using this plastic sheet protective covering. Now the next is power lines. So the power lines are structures that are used in electric power transmission and distribution to transmit electrical energy across large distances. As you can see from the figure, the transmission of data, or as you can say for a TV transmission, the power lines are used or power cables are used. In this electric cables, data signal or power signal is shown to you using the socket. Okay. Now, the next is fiber optics. Now, fiber optic cables are widely used nowadays and it provides the higher speed and better data security, as well as guarantee, or as you can say, high assurance of the data transmission. That's why fiber optic cables are used widely nowadays. So, fiber optic cables are similar to coaxial cables, except without the braid. Now, over here in this diagram, the two views are shown to you. The figure A is indicating the side view of the fiber optic cable, and the figure B is indicating the cross section view of the fiber optic cable. Now, from the figure A, you can say that there is a core of glass material, and above that, the cladding is also of glass material used over here. And in that, above a glass, or as you can say, above the glass material or cladding, the plastic jacket is provided. And the cross section view, that means in the figure B, there is a core, cladding, jacket, and the plastic or protective sheet, it is indicated, to obtain the fiber optic cable. Okay. Next is wireless transmission medium. So till now, what we have seen was the wire transmission medium, or as you can say, guided transmission medium. Now we will see the wireless transmission medium. Okay. That means in that there is no cables actually connected to transfer the data. So in this, the first one, we need to understand the electromagnetic spectrum, that means in which frequency what applications fall. The second will be radio transmission. The third is microwave transmission. The fourth one is infrared transmission or IR wave transmission. And the last one is light transmission. Okay, so let's see the first one, that is the electromagnetic spectrum. Now, the electromagnetic spectrum is shown over to you over here. In this, the different frequency range and its different frequency applications are shown. So, the particular frequency range for radio wave, microwaves, infrared, UV rays, X-rays or gamma rays are there. Or as you can say, visible light falls into some particular frequency range. That means below or above that frequency, we cannot see the light. Okay. Now, in this, the frequency bands are shown to you, which may be fall in the categories like lower frequency band, medium frequency band, high frequency band, medium frequency band, very high frequency band, or super high frequency band likewise. Okay, so according to the frequency band, there are some applications, whether it may be your radio transmission or maritime applications or satellite applications likewise. Okay, so to understand in which using the frequency ranges we can transmit the data, electromagnetic spectrum and its range are to be known to you. Okay. Next one is radio transmission. So, radio waves are easy to generate and they can travel longer distances and can penetrate the buildings easily. So, they are widely used for communications both for indoors and outdoors. So, whatever the radio stations you are listening to, that means your FM radio stations, they are using the radio wave transmission. Okay. So in the graph, in the diagram indicated to you is the ground wave transmission using the antenna according to the earth surface. Okay. Now in this radio transmission or radio broadcasting, different frequency range are allocated for different stations. That means, let's say for example, if you are listening to FM radio 1, that is tuned at the station 95. If you are listening to Radio Mirchi, it is tuned at the station 98.3. Right, so these are the tuned frequencies for the particular FM range. Okay. Next is microwave and infrared transmission. So above 100 megahertz, the waves travel in nearly straight lines and can therefore be narrowly focused. So above 100 megahertz, the waves are called as the microwaves. Then the unguided infrared and millimeter waves are widely used for short range communication. And the remote control used on televisions, VCRs and stereos all use infrared communication. So whenever you are using the remote control at your home for your TV or for your AC control, that are using the infrared communication. Okay. Now next is light transmission. So in this diagram, a bidirectional system with two lasers is indicated. In these two buildings are there, and using this light transmission, we can transfer the data, in which the first building has a photodetector, the second building has a laser beam which misses the detector having the laser beam. Okay. The next is satellite transmission, which are widely used nowadays using the communication satellites. So in this, the data transmission takes place using the different communication satellites outside the Earth surface. So there are basically three types of communication satellites. The first one is geostationary satellites. The second one is medium Earth orbit satellites, that is MEO. And the third one is lower Earth orbit satellites, that is LEO. Okay, so using different kind of satellites, we can transfer the data according to the applications or according to the requirement. So major broadcasting of news or TV channels are using the satellite communication. Alright. So these are the references for today's presentation. And I have used this for the topic physical layer. Now we will see in the next session PSTN, public switch telephone networks. And as well as we will see the different communication bases for the physical layer. Thank you. Thank you for listening.